Good evening, my friends. Good morning, or maybe even good afternoon, wherever you are. Welcome to Channel 48. My name is Buck. Well, I promised that we would get the G1 as well to receive a nice ROM, iOS ROM. And I'm here with the G100H, the SMG100H. And in fact, there is not too much development going on. We have Erwin ABS that is developing, or that in 2017 created a Lineage OS for this phone, and as well a Resurrection ROM that was, by the way, signed by Partheep. I'm not sure if these two are the same, but Erwin ABS and Partheep, they have a Resurrection and a Lineage OS for this phone. Okay, I'm talking about Nougat 7.12. So I didn't find too many other developers that I kind of created a ROM for this phone, but King Cobra also created a ROM a while ago, and it's even after, I think the date was, let me see and take a quick look, okay, and it was created on the 31st of December 2017, so that is 8 months ago. And I think it was even after the CM14 and the Resurrection. So let's go ahead and install it. I modded the ROM. Okay, the ROM is by King Cobra. King Cobra 89, I think it was. Let me see, what is his name? 97, sorry for that. King Cobra 97. He's the man of this ROM. So whatever you're gonna see and whatever I modded was thanks to Mr. King Cobra. Okay, let's rumble. So we're gonna put the phone into a recovery mode. And there is also another ROM for this phone, but unfortunately it's on KitKat and it was never ever updated. I did update certain parts of the ROM. It's a one-on-one iOS ROM. But yeah, it's KitKat, you know, it's very old. And this is even a bit more recent. And what I'm going to do is advanced wipe, system data, internal storage and cache. Just going to wipe the complete thing, so we can make a clean start. Okie doke, we go back. And we're gonna say install, and here it is, iOS X ROM G100H by King Cobra 97, and the mod by Puckrom, and the date is today. So cross fingers, guys, ladies and gentlemen, let's just cross our fingers. Let's cross our fingers. Come on, let's cross our fingers. My phone is booting up. Guantanamera. Wadia Guantanamera. There we go. I'm just doing a real time, okay, so you can see the complete process. And this, in fact, is gonna be a very nice system because of certain things that you're gonna see just now, but I promise this will look really nice. And it's also built on solid ground. And the applications that I implemented will give you a certain kind of security, to say it this way. Most of the applications that you don't trust, you will be able to block, you know, in the firewall, because you're gonna have root access.
So yeah, you will have to protect yourself a bit as well. In the privacy guard, you can go through, you know, through all the permissions like you never could before. So that is really, really cool. Okay. And we're even gonna have a beautiful, colorful settings part. It will not be iOS, but it will look very cool. It will be in the style of iOS, okay? Because, yeah, in these versions of Android, we didn't have no colorful menu. We did, of course, in the TouchWiz StockROM that we had. Of course, it was colorful, black with colors. About the same thing that I showed in the previous video on Nougat. This is not Nougat, this is Marshmallow. But hey, I did not test this ROM yet. I should give it a chance, you know. I'm happy to find another ROM than from Arian ABS and Partheap. I'm happy to see that somebody else is also, yeah, but it all stopped at December 2017. It all stopped then. So yeah, there is no development anymore going on for this phone. That while this is a very nice phone, the G100H. It's a real cool phone. Really nothing wrong with it. Look at the size. Fits nice in your pocket. It's elegant. It has enough cores. I mean, yeah, enough power to run Android. Depending on what you're gonna run, of course. I'm not running all these things, you know, so probably it's not powerful enough anymore for certain, I don't know, you know, but I don't do these things. As a phone and as my record mate, my whatever, you know, all the things that I do, I can do with this phone. So it's not a bad phone. This is a multimedia phone, it's great. So, okay, we install the ROM. We're gonna reboot. We reboot to the system.
Don't install SuperSue, okay?
Big mosquito. Damn. These animals, they like me. But not for long. Okay, it's rebooting. And now it should boot into the... I never ever installed this ROM before, so I'm not even knowing if it's working. Oh, it's working, okay. Because I modded the ROM and in fact I downloaded the ROM. I did not test the ROM and I immediately modded the ROM. And I grabbed my camera and I thought, let's make a video real fast because I promised it. So yeah. I'm kinda improving. I make before testing. But of course that is also thanks to this good ROM, eh? I'm not knowing how good the ROM is, but it looks sure good to me. Until now. It looks very good. You see all the applications are being installed. This is Marshmallow. From December 2017, so yeah, it's acceptable. Nobody's gonna create ever an update for this. I might contact King Cobra and ask him if he would like to, you know, update this version still. Not knowing how it works, we must first see if it works good. Because if it does, if it's not stable or so, then we don't have. But I think it's gonna be. This is CM13. CM13 is very stable, at least the way I know CM13. But that doesn't say anything. It's all about how is the ROM developed. And we're almost there, preparing to start. There we are, my friends. Sayonarion, what? Hello. How are you, my old friend? I never forgot about you. Okay, Wi-Fi is found. We're gonna skip. It feels so great. It feels different. It says SIM card is missing, but probably it will soon connect to the SIM. Next, you see, SIM is already connected. See that there in the corner on top? SIM is connected. Oh, beautiful. Look at this. iOS launcher, just deny everything, okay? Don't let it connect to your location, otherwise it's gonna crash the launcher whenever you're gonna swipe to the right. Because up there is the weather app. So we say, okay, got it. And there we are. Oh, lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. You see? Everything here, we're gonna say deny. It's gonna ask again, location, say deny and deny. Otherwise, this thing is gonna give an error. This. Whenever you're gonna click it, it's gonna crash the browser. You see? And in fact, that is a bug of the launchers. Yeah. Don't worry about it. It's not about the weather. If you want to know the weather, look outside and feel if it's hot or cold, right? Or just install some weather app. Okay, so now we're not done yet. What we now need to do is we go to the theme chooser. Okay, because now we're gonna fix the settings. And we go for my beautiful theme here and we say okay. This is amazing theme. I'm so happy with this theme, really. It brought so much more life back to CM 11 and 12. And of course, thumbs up to APK Pure for hosting this beautiful theme, the CM themes. And there you go, we fixed the settings. Look at that. Is that not beautiful, guys? And girls, what you say? Huh? What you say? Can I have a thumbs up for this? This is looks so great. It feels so snappy. Okay, but. Is the camera working? That is kind of important, huh? We must know if the camera works. And let's put the browser there. There's the browser. Let's give it a nice little place there. I love my clock on the front page here. Because this is live tile. I mean, not live tile. Live icons. You see, we also have YouTube. This is a YouTube app that will work without the services installed. And I added a new player. I don't even see it. Let me see where it is. Or maybe it's not in this mod yet. We have FM radio. FM radio, peeps. Your FM radio is back. King Cobra, King Cobra, King Cobra. Here I have a new music app. That one I want to give prominent place on the front page. You see that? We have APK Pure Store. We have our firewall installed. We have live TV. NPO for my Dutch people. And about the NPO, guys, listen up. Ook mijn Nederlandse kijkers. If you're gonna click it, you're gonna get a pop-up. Yeah. It's gonna cry. It's gonna say this app is you don't have Google Play service. It's not blah blah. It's not possible to use Google Chromecast. Okay, so this thing has no Chromecast support. Just say don't worry about it. You know, don't go hit install or update. Don't try to make it better because you're gonna end up with the app that will not work because there is no Google Play service installed on this phone. Okay, and I'm also not gonna install it because it's gonna make this phone slow. So we hit okay. Okay, this app is good to go for the next coming 10 years. Okay, this is just to listen to radio, Dutch radio, live, you know, and the public TV from the Netherlands. 1, 2, 3, NPO news, politics. This is for the Dutch people, but of course, I also watch American politics, so if you like to watch Dutch TV, you are welcome to watch. I'm not sure if they will play with your IP number, but don't think that this app is not good, okay? Good. So, about the iMusic player, this is very nice music player. You see that? Nice, huh? Look at that keyboard. Amazing. Bitdefender. You hit accept. You turn on and say allow. Then you can start a scan. You see? It will scan your device. And if something is wrong there, it's gonna let you know. You see, it's safe. And whenever you're gonna download something that is not safe, you will immediately get a warning. And then Bitdefender will ask you if you want Bitdefender to uninstall it because it's malware or Trojan or whatsoever. You know, and you also have your own APK Pure store. I mean, like, oh yeah, let me show you that. Many people have problems with APK Pure. APK Pure is a nice app store, but the application itself, it kind of tricks once in a while, okay? And I'm gonna show you that. Up here, it's asking you to access your media files, say yes, and the phone we deny, okay? It does not need the phone to make phone calls, etc. So, but once in a while, whenever you're gonna download something, so let's say I want to download WhatsApp. I'm soon gonna also show you how to set up the keyboard, because this is not a iOS styled keyboard the way it types. Okay, so let's say you hit install. Sometimes it's gonna tell you it could not install permissions. You must, you know, and then you go to the permissions. Let me show you that part real fast. Let's go to the settings. Settings, and then permissions. App permissions. Yeah, and then up here you can go to the app permissions. Gonna load all the applications, and then up here you're gonna see that your storage, for instance, is used by APK Pure as well. You see that? But sometimes you must turn it on and turn it off again before it actually starts downloading. Okay, that's the issue of the store. But when it cannot do that, it will itself bring you to this part where you're gonna see three little buttons that you can, you know, turn on and off, and then you make sure that only the storage is on, and then you go back, and then suddenly it downloads. Okay, I'm not planning to download WhatsApp on this device, but that's how it works. All right.
What more can I show you? It's all about you testing it and playing with it and discovering where the stuck ups are. Sometimes probably you will run into a situation that your touchscreen is not working anymore, and the best way to fix that is to remove the battery and just reboot the device again. Remember, this is still a custom ROM and it was not officially developed, so probably there will be some bugs here and there, but I think it's really cool to see that at least somebody else is as well, you know, taking the time to work on this phone. So to King Cobra, I would like to say, yo, hey, if it's still possible to update CM13. I'm not sure if, you know, with the Lineage 13 patches, if it's possible to, I think it should be possible. I would say update this thing and continue the work on it, because, yeah, there are enough people still using this phone. And to tell you the honest, really, truth, I tested many ROMs, at least the ones that are available. I tested them all. And I did not find any of them like really, really good. There was always something that was not, you know, that good. Maybe cam or maybe something else, you know. There are always some little issues that you might run into. But if you know how to set up the device, then you can also get rid of these issues. And I also said earlier that the FM radio, I'm doing a new setup of this operating system, because I also tested something else in meantime. Many hours went by after I came back to finish this video effect. And at this point, I just reinstalled this OS that I just showed you. Here it is, we are back to start. And I want to check something. I want to see if the FM radio is working now, because I wanted to. Okay, to start listening, plug in headphones. I did not get error yet. Yesterday I was already getting an error here. Talking about this, see that? I'm gonna plug it in. Start listening to plug in. I plugged it in. Unfortunately, Bluetooth share has stopped. You see? And then we click that away. But I put it on speaker. It's on speaker. I don't hear nada. So yeah, the FM radio does not work, okay? So, yeah, depending on what you're doing with the phone, if you're not doing banking and things like that, I think maybe the very best ROM to install on this phone will be the official stock ROM, and then just disable all these, you know, apps. Just disable them, get root access really easy. Maybe we should do a project on that, you know, and use the official stock ROM that was created for this phone, the KitKat ROM. And even though it's very outdated, but with some good tools and with root access, we could in fact mask these, you know, these broken windows in the house, and hope that we don't get all these bats and crazy birds fly into the house. But you will at least have an operating system on the phone that will probably not fail in certain things and will be reasonable fast. Okay? Because yesterday I did run into some problems with this ROM. I wanted to give you, in fact, the best review on this ROM available on YouTube. And I must tell you that I did get some stock ups, and here and there the whole thing was stuck and I could not move the screen anymore, and I just had to remove the battery. So I want to give it a new chance, because maybe I also did some crazy things. You know, I was busy and filming and doing all sorts of things, showing. And then sometimes it's getting a little bit too much for the device as well. So yeah, but if we're gonna use it just like a phone, it's at this moment. Also, I'm not sure if I showed you that the phone was working. Phone works fine. Everything, in fact, works fine. So what I'm gonna do, I'm again gonna hit the theme the very beautiful theme here and just add the settings part. And then in fact, I'm done. And this could also be done on, in fact, should you have root to do this? Let me think. I think you could also do it without root. Because if you flash the twerp to this phone, whenever it's still in original state, you wipe the drives, you can then in fact immediately install this ROM. You don't have to, this ROM is pre-rooted, so you won't have to do anything. It will just be an install after that, you know, after you did a wipe of the drives and cleaned up all the drives, you know. Best would be to wipe the internal storage, just like what I did. And there is the theme, it's already set it up. It's so beautiful. I love this theme, eh? It's really lovely. It brought life back to this phone, at least to CM13 and CM12. In 14, that theme engine was removed. I don't know why they did it. I feel very sad about that they did it. Because in fact, it made Lineage OS kind of boring to look at in the settings, eh? I mean, yeah. And nobody thought about, you know, replacing these icons. This might also happen, that out of nothing, the phone goes into a reboot if you did something strange with the launcher. So, yeah, I'm not sure if it's the best ROM to use, but go ahead, test it out. Link will be in the description. Link to King Cobra's ROM Untouched will be there, so you can also test that one to see if you run into less issues. Maybe my apps that I pushed into the ROM, maybe the ROM does not like it, you know. Could be that because of that these things are happening. But I'm just gonna give it one more chance and test it out even better and see if things will, yeah, improve, or yeah, if this is just a matter of some first start up errors, you know, and then after that they are getting fixed, and in fact you don't have to worry anymore and it just works fine. So I will have to find out about that. Thank you for watching. Go play with your G100 King Cobra. Thank you very much. And of course, watchers, if you think this video was useful, leave it a thumbs up. Of course, subscribe to my channel after you also hit the notifying bell, so you'll be updated whenever I upload a new video again. Until then, peace out.